हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द टारगेट यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2024 एमसीक्यू सीरीज. द सब्जेक्ट वी विल बी कवरिंग टुडे इज इकोनॉमी एंड दिस इज द सेवेंथ एपिसोड ऑफ इकोनॉमी. सो लेट्स बिगिन. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रेफरेंस टू न्यू इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी 1991. सो इन टोटल देर आर थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स. फर्स्ट, डी रिजर्वेशन ऑफ ऑल द गवर्नमेंट इंडस्ट्रीज टुक प्लेस. सेकेंड, डिस इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक सेक्टर टुक प्लेस टू इंश्योर और टू इन्हेंस देयर एफिशियंसी एंड कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस. थर्ड, दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी इन विच फॉरन कंपनीज वर अलाउड टू हैव मेजोरिटी स्टेक इन इंडिया. विच ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट्स गिवन अबव आर करेक्ट. वन एंड टू ओनली, टू एंड थ्री ओनली, वन एंड थ्री ओनली और वन टू एंड थ्री. सो the correct answer of this question is option B, that is 2 and 3 only. So first statement is wrong. Let's see. So the long awaited liberalized industrial policy was announced by the government of India in the year 1991 in the midst of severe economic instability. So there was severe economic instability in the country. The objective of the policy was to raise efficiency and accelerate economic growth acceleration. So, features of new industrial policy were first de-reservation of public sector. So, the sectors that were earlier exclusively reserved for public sector were reduced. However, preeminent place of public sector in five core areas like arms and ammunition, atomic energy, mineral oils, rail transport and mining was continued. Therefore, statement one becomes wrong, that all the government industries took place. No, five core areas did not took place. Now let's talk about de-licensing. Abolition of industrial licensing for all projects except for a short list of industries. There are only four industries at present related to security, strategic and environmental concerns where an industrial license is currently required. Electronic aerospace and defense equipment, specified hazardous chemicals, industrial explosives, cigars and cigarettes of tobacco and manufactured tobacco substitutes. Then comes the topic of disinvestment of public sector. So, government stakes in public sector enterprises were reduced to enhance their efficiency and competitiveness. Therefore, second becomes correct. Now, let's talk about liberalization of foreign investment. This was the first industrial policy in which foreign companies were allowed to have majority stake in India. So, now the foreign companies also were allowed to have majority stake in India. Therefore, third statement becomes correct. For export trading houses, FDI up to 74% was allowed. Today, there are numerous sectors in the economy where government is also allowing 100% of FDI. Therefore, third statement also becomes correct. With regard to the foreign technology agreement, automatic approvals for technology related agreements. So, the correct answer for this question becomes option B, that is 2 and 3 only. Next, which of the following is characteristic feature of market gardening? Farms are of very large size. Netherlands is an example of market gardening. It is well developed in sparsely populated areas of Northwest Europe. It is practiced in the areas where consumers of low income group are located. Correct answer is option B, that is Netherlands is an example of market gardening. Now, first of all, what is market gardening? So, market gardening specializes in cultivation of high value crops such as vegetables, fruits, flowers, solely for the urban market. So, it is for the urban markets. So, farms are small in size and are located where there are good transportation links with the urban centers where high income group of consumers is located. So first becomes wrong. Then it is both labor and कैपिटल इंटेंसिव एंड लेस एम्फेसिस ऑन द यूज ऑफ इरिगेशन, HYV सीड्स, फर्टिलाइजर्स, इंसेक्टिसाइड्स, ग्रीन हाउस एंड आर्टिफिशियल हीटिंग इन कोल्डर रीजन्स. देन दिस टाइप ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इज वेल डिवेलप्ड इन डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड इंडस्ट्रियल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट यूरोप, नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एंड द मेडिटेरेनियन रीजन. सो इट इज नॉट स्पेसली पॉपुलेटेड, इट इज डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड. देन द नेदरलैंड स्पेशलाइजेज इन ग्रोइंग फ्लावर्स एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर क्रॉप्स, स्पेशली ट्यूलिप्स विच आर फ्लोन टू ऑल मेजर सिटीज ऑफ यूरोप, स्पेशली ट्यूलिप्स. Therefore, option B becomes correct. Next, in India, which of the following can be considered as public investment in agriculture? Fixing minimum support price for agricultural produce of all crops, computerization of primary agricultural credit societies, social capital development, free electricity supply to farmers, waiver of agricultural loans by the banking system, or setting up of cold storage facilities by the governments. Select the correct answer using the code given below. 1, 2 and 5 only, 1, 3, 4 and 5 only, 2, 3 and 6 only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 only. Correct answer is option C, that is 2, 3 and 6. Let's see. Public investment is an investment by the state, like central, state and local governments, or through publicly owned companies. To build the nation's capital stock, build nation's capital stock by devoting resources to the basic physical infrastructure, like for example roads, bridges, rail lines, airports, water distribution, innovative activities, green investments and education that leads to higher productivity or higher living standards. Then MSP, that is minimum support price, it provides a market intervention mechanism to work as an insurance policy. So it works as an insurance policy for the farmers to save them from price falls. It is not helping in enhancing productivity in the agriculture sector. So it is not helping in enhancing productivity in the agriculture sector. Thus, fixing the MSP for agricultural produce of all crops does not add to national capital stock or lead to higher productivity. Therefore, first is not correct. Computerization of primary agricultural credit societies, it will enhance productivity in the agriculture sector as there will be easy and timely access of credit. So, easy and timely access of credit. Therefore, second is correct. Cold storage facilities. Cold storage facilities are commonly built to store perishable goods. So, to store perishable goods. For a period of time, government does not set up cold storage of its own. Government is implementing various schemes under which financial assistance is provided for setting up of cold storage, for storage of agriculture produce, including perishable horticulture produce throughout the country. Therefore, sixth is also correct. Then comes the point of social capital is the value that can be created through networking and trust built within and between people and organization. So, then comes third, that is social capital. So, social capital also helps in the public investments. Then free electricity. Free electricity to farmers has apart from financial stress on the state. So, this puts financial stress on the state. Resulted in excess use of water, encouragement of installation of more pump sets and depleting groundwater table. Therefore, fourth is not correct. Then, waiver of agricultural loans is not investment as it affects the health of the banking sector. Therefore, five is also not correct. Fourth is not correct, five is not correct, first is not correct. Therefore, the correct answer is option C, that is 2, 3 and 6. Next, fixation of price levels for wheat and rice by the CACP, that is Commission for Agriculture Costs and Prices, is an example of administered price, market price, control price or support price. The correct answer is option D, that is support price. तो कमीशन फॉर एग्रीकल्चरल कॉस्ट एंड प्राइसेस दैट इज CACP, इट इज अ डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड एजेंसी अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर. फिक्सेशन ऑफ प्राइस लेवल्स फॉर वीट एंड राइस बाय द CACP इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सपोर्ट प्राइसिंग. इट इज द सपोर्ट ऑफ सर्टेन प्राइस लेवल्स एट और अबव मार्केट वैल्यूज. एट और अबव मार्केट वैल्यूज बाय द गवर्नमेंट. देयरफॉर ऑप्शन डी इज करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट, विद रेफरेंस टू ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इन इंडिया कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट. तो देर आर थ्री स्टेटमेंट गिवन. फर्स्ट, द NPOP विच इज नेशनल प्रोग्राम फॉर ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्शन is operated under the guidelines and directions of the Union Ministry of Rural Development. Second, the Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority, that is APEDA, functions as the secretariat for the implementation of NPOP. Third, Sikkim has become India's first fully organic state. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? 1 and 2 only, 2 and 3 only, 3 only, 1, 2 and 3. करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, दैट इज 2 and 3 ओनली. तो सेकेंड एंड थर्ड इज करेक्ट, फर्स्ट इज इनकरेक्ट. लेट्स सी. द नेशनल प्रोग्राम फॉर ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्शन ऑपरेट्स अंडर द गाइडलाइंस एंड डायरेक्शंस ऑफ द यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. देयरफॉर फर्स्ट बिकम्स रॉन्ग. एनपीओपी प्रपोजेस टू प्रोवाइड एन इंस्टीट्यूशनल मैकेनिज्म फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ National standards for organic production through a national accreditation policy and program. The aims of the NPOP includes the following: to provide the means of evaluation of certification programs for organic agriculture and products as per the approved criteria, to accredit certification programs, to facilitate certification of organic products in conformity to the national standards for organic products, to encourage the development of organic farming and organic processing. The APEDA was established by the Government of India under the Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority Act 1985. It functions as the secretariat for the implementation of the NPOP. Therefore, second becomes correct. Then, in 2016, Sikkim became India's first fully organic state by implementing organic practices on around 75,000 hectares of agricultural land. Therefore, third is also correct. Therefore, correct is 2 and 3. So, option B, that is 2 and 3 only, becomes the correct answer. Now, next question, which talks about... Next question is... Okay, this is the next question. Which one of the following was not a part of the strategies followed by the government of India to increase food grain production in India immediately after independence? It is saying immediately after independence. So, India got independence in the year 1947. Now, intensification of cropping over already cultivated land. Increasing cultivable area by bringing cultivable and fallow land under plug, using high yielding variety seeds, or switching over from cash crop to food crops. So the answer is option C. The Indian economy was largely a self-sufficient economy before the arrival of the colonial government. So earlier it was self-sufficient. But during the colonial rule, the Indian economy saw a setback in the form of low productivity. So during colonial rule, there was low productivity in agricultural and allied activities. After independence, the main aim of the government was to achieve self-sufficiency in Indian agriculture. Indian policymakers adopted several measures to achieve self-sufficiency in food grains with the help of the following steps. First, intensification of cropping over already cultivated land. The utilization of land at its full potential via increasing cultivable area by bringing cultivable and fallow land under plug, switching over from cash crops to food crops. These three were the part of it, but the one which was not part of it is option C, So, using high yielding variety seeds were not immediately introduced in Indian agriculture after independence. It was introduced after a certain period of time. Immediately, it was not introduced. It was introduced during the 1960s during the Green Revolution. Since the advent of the Green Revolution, the country has avoided famines. So, after that, famines did not take place even during severe weather conditions. Therefore, the correct answer is option C. Next, which are the advantages of implementing the National Agriculture Market Scheme? National Agriculture Market Scheme, there are two statements. It is a pan-India electronic trading portal for agricultural commodities. Second, it provides the farmers access to nationwide market with prices commensurate with the quality of the produce. Select the correct answer using the code given below. One only, two only, both one and two, neither one nor two. Correct answer is option C, that is both one and two. So NAM, that is the National Agriculture Market Scheme. National Agriculture Market Scheme, it is a pan-India electronic trading portal which networks the existing agricultural produce. Therefore, statement one becomes correct. The NAM portal provides a single window service for all APMC. So, it provides a single window service for all APMC. For all APMC related information and services. This includes commodity arrivals and prices, buy and sell, trade offers, provision to respond to trade offers, among other services. So, agriculture marketing is administered by the states. So, it is administered by the states as per their agri marketing regulations, under which the state is divided into several market areas, each of which is administered by a separate APMC, which imposes its own marketing regulation. Then it also provides the farmers access to the nationwide market with prices commensurate with the quality of their produce. So whatever will be the quality, the prices will commensurate with regard to it. Therefore, statement 2 is also correct. The correct answer becomes option C, that is both 1 and 2. Next, consider the following statements. There are two statements. First, the accelerated irrigation benefits program. So, accelerated irrigation benefits program was launched during the 1996-97 to provide loan assistance to poor farmers. Loan assistance. The command area development program. Command Area Development Program was launched in 1974-75 for the development of water use efficiency. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? One only, two only, both one and two, neither one nor two. Correct answer is option B, that is two only. So, second is correct, first is incorrect. Let's see. The Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program was launched during 1996-97 to provide financial assistance to the states to expedite completion of ongoing major medium irrigation, including extensive renovation and modernization of irrigation projects and surface minor irrigation schemes, as well as lift irrigation scheme. So, lift irrigation scheme. Therefore, statement 1 is incorrect. So, loan assistance is not there. To poor farmers, it is providing financial assistance to the states. Second, the centrally sponsored command area development program. So, it was centrally sponsored. It was launched during 1974-75 with the main objectives of improving the utilization of created irrigation potential and optimizing agricultural production and productivity from irrigated agriculture through a multidisciplinary team under the Area Development Authority. Therefore, second becomes correct for the development of water use efficiency. So, because it is related to irrigation. Therefore, the correct answer is option B. Next. Consider the following statement. The union government fixes the statutory minimum price of sugar cane for each sugar season. शुगर एंड शुगर केन आर असेंशियल कमोडिटीज अंडर द असेंशियल कमोडिटीज एक्ट. विच ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट्स गिवन अबव इज और आर करेक्ट? वन ओनली, टू ओनली, बोथ वन एंड टू, नीदर वन नॉर टू. करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, दैट इज बोथ वन एंड टू. लेट्स सी, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द एफ आर पी, दैट इज द फेयर एंड रेम्यूनरेटिव प्राइस फॉर शुगर केन्स, इज डिटरमाइंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द रिकमेंडेशन बाय द सी ए सी पी एंड आफ्टर कंसल्टेशन विद द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स. तो कंसल्टेशन इज डन बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स एंड अदर स्टेक होल्डर्स. इट इज देन फाइनली अप्रूव्ड बाय द कैबिनेट कमिटी ऑन इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स. तो कैबिनेट कमिटी ऑन इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स फाइनली अप्रूव्स इट, विच इज हेडेड बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. देन हेंस स्टेटमेंट वन इज करेक्ट. सो द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट फिक्सेस द स्टैट्यूटरी मिनिमम प्राइस ऑफ शुगर केन फॉर ईच शुगर सीजन. बोथ शुगर एंड शुगर केन आर इनलिस्टेड अंडर द असेंशियल कमोडिटीज एक्ट. तो शुगर एंड शुगर केन आर असेंशियल कमोडिटीज अंडर द असेंशियल कमोडिटीज एक्ट. देयरफॉर सेकंड ऑल्सो बिकम्स करेक्ट. द एक्ट एम्पावर्स द सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स कॉन्करेंटली टू कंट्रोल प्रोडक्शन, सप्लाई एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सर्टेन कमोडिटीज इन व्यू ऑफ राइजिंग प्राइसेस. देयरफॉर ऑप्शन टू ऑल्सो बिकम्स करेक्ट. In 2020, government amended the Essential Commodities Act of 1955 and inserted a new subsection. Therefore, the correct answer is option C. Next. So, next question is about, with reference to ENAM, consider the following statements. There are two statements. It promotes uniformity in agriculture marketing by streamlining procedures across the integrated markets. Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium, that is SFAC, is the lead agency for implementing ENAM. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? One only, two only, both one and two, neither one nor two. So the correct answer for this is option C, that is both one and two. So ENAM, which is National Agriculture Market, is a pan India electronic trading portal. So it is a pan India electronic trading portal which networks the existing APMC. So it APMC mandis to create a unified national market for agricultural commodities. It promotes uniformity in agriculture marketing by streamlining procedures across the integrated market, removing information asymmetry between buyers and sellers, and promoting real-time price discovery based on actual demand and supply. Therefore, first is correct. Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium is the lead agency for implementing ENAM under the aegis of the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Therefore, second also becomes correct. Therefore, both are correct. Option C is the correct answer. Next is, and this is the practice question, and like always, you people will give me the answer in the comment section. Which of the following statements are correct regarding the green revolution in India? The demand for agricultural credit has increased. There has been displacement of labor from urban to rural areas. It had adverse effects on the distribution of income in rural areas. Select the correct answer using the code given below. 1 and 2 only, 2 and 3 only, 1 and 3 only, or all of the above. So that's all for today. Give me the answer in the comment section. Then that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Till we meet next time, keep reading, keep writing, and keep subscribing to the channel. Thank you.
For more informative content, like, share, and subscribe. And do not forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications.